Let's start with the gear. The first is of course the basic clothing under the armor. Let's start with the armor. The first piece of this assembling of armor is this jerkin. This jerkin is not simply padded like most Van Eckmans goods with a woolen fleece, wool or a synthetic fleece. This one is already real armor. It's made from 18 layers of linen and weighs around 6.8 kilos. So not just decoration or a simple padding under the coat of mail, but it's already real armor and would protect his owner already very well against any kind of weaponry of this period. Swords, arrows or also spears would have really problems to break through this kind of padding. The next piece for the armor is a coat of mail. It's a typical coat of mail of the early medieval times. It's not very long, it has short sleeves. This particular replica is based on the Sutton Hoo Shipbuilder 1 finding. We had the X-rays and did a reconstruction as good as possible. It's made from riveted rings and cut rings. They are very small, just 6 millimeters in diameter, and the roll coat of mail weighs 7.2 kilos. The next piece of the gear is the sword belt. The belt itself has not just the task to carry the sword or purse or sacks or whatever with you, but also to take some weight from your shoulders and transfers to your hips. Therefore the belt has to be very tight, but it makes it very comfortable even to wear such a heavy garniture like I wear here in this video. And of course the Sparta, the secondary weapon with a very long wide blade, perfectly for cutting but also for thrusting. Here the arm guards. These arm guards are inspired by Walsgärde 8. In this grave they found very decorated arm guards made of these steel strips. This one are just functionally without decoration. Finally the helmet. This one is a replica of the Pioneer Wollaston helmet, UK. As you see, this type of helmet is the very typical ones for the early medieval times in Great Britain. We have just one more model of this type, and that's the Coppergate helmet, but the Pioneer Wollaston helmet is much easier and just functional. Then the shield. You know my shield replica of Sutton Hoo Burial Mount 17 already. I posted a video about riding with this kind of shield. Here again you see the construction, how this shield is made. It's not too large, so you can move from side to side on horseback. This replica is made from pine wood and leather. Here a throwing spear with a very arrowhead-like spear point and a much heavier lance. Use it for close combat with a blade-like spear point. The first and very important for all daily use with the horse is the halter. You see my reconstruction here, it's very period neutral. The base is made from hemp cord and the rope is made from horsehair. Herr Aragon's bridle. One compromise is that the original is a broken bit. I have a stiff bit. Aragon prefers stiff bits. The base of this bridle is the Sutton Hoo Burial Mount 70 bridle found 1994, but the construction we made of all the single fittings is totally different, nearly totally different, to the publication made by Martin Carver, because his interpretation is simply not usable, and I tried together with some very good craftsmen to make a replica which is really usable for traveling and also for combat. Then we come to the saddle. This saddle is based on Rulstorf, Germany, and Wesel-Bislich in Germany. You see, I have already stirrups. In the early 7th century, stirrups were already common, but they are made from wood and reinforced with rawhide. The saddle itself is very small. You see just the high cantle and the high fork of this saddle, and the seat itself is very tight to hold the rider light, like in a tongue. The first thing you have to do is padding the horseback before you put the saddle on. I use therefore a thick blanket made from wool felt. Then finally the saddle. As I told you already, these saddles, at least my reconstruction and also the iconography, tells us that these saddles were very tight made, so that the rider itself cannot simply be pulled out of the saddle during a combat. Finally, before mounting, of course the horse needs his bridle. As all the gear and tack I show you in this video, everything is made on measurement for me and for Aragon 2. This has of course security reasons. A good fitting armor protects you in all situations, and especially the saddle and the bridle have to be made perfectly on the horse to sit comfortable and to not distribute your horse, or even worse, to hurt your horse.